So, hello everybody, welcome back. This is the fourth and final part of our tutorial on how to use Ambisonics audio in Ableton Live 10. And in the previous two parts, we looked into how to create Ambisonics audio using Envelope for Live, and then how to monitor immersive audio using Waves NX. And in this part, we're going to look into how to record Ambisonics audio on our Mac. Unfortunately, Ableton can't do that natively, so we cannot simply bounce the track. So what we need is a separate application that takes in the audio from Ableton and records it onto our hard drive. And in order to be able to do that, we need a device that takes 16 channels out of one software and channels it into another software. So we need a virtual audio device. That's essentially what we need. On Windows, you would use a driver. On Mac, you use a particular software that can create such an audio device. And the software that we are going to use is called Loopback. It's from a company called Rogue Amoeba. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Strange name, great software, which is true. And this software is particularly nice because you can use it for all kinds of things. I'm, for example, using it in order to route the audio out of Spotify directly into Ableton so that I can use Spotify to reference my mixes in Ableton directly. So there are many different ways to use that. We are going to use it in order to be able to take the 16 channels, third order ambisonics information out of Ableton and put it onto our hard drive. I already set up everything, so I already installed everything once again because I wanted to make sure that everything is working correctly with the screen recording software. But I'm just going to show you some of the key things you need to take care of when you install or run this software. So I'm opening up Loopback. What I've essentially done is I have created a virtual device which I called Third Order Ambisonics. And this virtual device, I gave it 16 channels, 1 through 16. And the other thing that I did is I set it up such that it monitors, or the audio is monitored through menu bus. So I enabled the monitoring option and set it to menu bus so that when the 16 channels are coming into this virtual device, they are not only passed on to the recording application, but it's also passed on to menu bus so that I actually hear what I'm recording. Now, it doesn't really matter that menu bus can only take 6 channels and actually only needs the first 4 channels. The other channels are simply ignored. So essentially what's happening is that the 16 channels are passed on to menu bus. Menu bus takes the first 6 channels, forgets channels 5 and 6, and takes the other 4 channels, routes it to Waves NX, and Waves NX then processes it and turns that into a stereo signal that I can hear. So I've now created this virtual device. It's already live on my system. I've enabled it here. So what I need to do now is I need to use this device as my output device in Ableton. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. So I'm going to go into the preferences of Ableton. And from the previous part of this tutorial, we had menu bus as the output device. I'm now going to change that to our new virtual device, which we call Third Order Ambisonics. And I'm just making sure that all the output channels are enabled. So I go into output configuration and I see that all the outputs from 1 to 16 are all enabled. So all 16 output channels are now available to me. So the next thing I need to make sure is that these 16 channels are actually kind of taken or connected to the 16 outputs of the Envelope for Live system. Currently, in the output routing, I only set the first 4. So the thing I need to do is I need to also connect the other channels, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and the final one. And what I have now is I have created a situation where the audio is now routed, or all 16 channels are now routed into this virtual device. This virtual device takes these 16 channels. It's currently not yet connected to recording software, but it takes the first 6 channels and puts them to menu bus where I can essentially monitor them. So if I'm playing the loop now, I should actually hear it in the very same way we heard it before. Let's just try that. So it's still doing the head tracking thing. It's working correctly. So I've now taken care of the first part. So the audio is now leaving Ableton, and all I need to do now is to take that virtual device and record whatever is passed through that virtual device. So all I really need is a recording application, and you can use any audio recording application that can handle multi-channel output. The obvious choice would be to use Audacity, especially if you are on a Windows system, that would be the thing to do. We are, however, going to use a different system, and the reason I'm going to use a different software is because I want to have a software that is as lean as possible, that does not add a lot of processing on top of it. So I want a software that essentially all it really does is recording. And the one that we are going to use is called RecAll, RecordAll. It's from a company called Audified. And it's really only recording. That's all there is to it. So it's taking input, recording it, and that's it. Nothing more. And that's exactly what we need. So let's start this recording application, RecAll. Now, when you start it up, it asks you what you or how do you want to set it up. And usually what you would do is you would create a new project, you would define 16 mono channels for the 16 different Ambisonics channels, and you would give it a name, and then it would come up. I've already done that. So there is a project already on my system that I called Third Order Ambisonics. Not to confuse with the virtual device, that is actually the RecAll project that has the same name, so it's not the virtual device. I'm opening that, and what I'm getting is a setup with 16 mono channels, and I renamed these mono channels to represent the 16 official Ambisonics names. So it's Ambix 0 to Ambix 15. And when I record those, so that I already have those named in the correct way. One thing I need to make sure is that everything is set up correctly. So I'm going into the preferences, and I'm just making sure that it's listening to the correct device. So in this case, it's listening to the Third Order Ambisonics device. That was that virtual device that I set up in loopback. And on the recording option, I just want to make sure that I'm having the correct format that I want. For example, I can choose to save it in traditional wave format. I can do that. So let's do it like that. So if I now play the track again, the audio should now be passed through to our recording software. And indeed it is. So essentially the audio, the way it comes from Envelope for Life, is now passed on to RecAll, the recording software, and at the same time through Menu Bus, where it is processed through Waves and X in order for me to be able to monitor it in an immersive way. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. All I now need to do is to just press the record button. So if I'm ready to record anything, all I do I'm doing is I'm pressing record, and it's now recording. Okay, stop. And let's stop the audio as well. Now when it's recording that to a particular directory. And I'm just kind of opening that up. And it's essentially kind of, it shows the first take. And if you open up the first take, you see the 16 Ambisonics channels separated. They're all mono WAV files that you can now use in any way you want. So for example, you could use just the first 4, 0 to 3, as first order Ambisonics information. So for example, if you're doing something in Facebook VR or in YouTube VR, you would take those and feed them or kind of use them with the appropriate software so that you have the immersive audio in that VR system. Or if you're doing game development in Unity, you can set up that as well and use those audio channels for that as well. The one thing you need to just be aware of that is that we currently having a particular type of content ordering. So the components, the ambisonics components are ordered according to ambix. That is not the only way people order ambisonics components. So there are a couple of other options out there. So sometimes you might come across the requirement that you need to have them in what's called FUMA component ordering. And if that happens, all you really need to do is you need to reorder those components. It's not really doing anything else but just kind of changing the order of the channels. However, these days, most of the software that you're going to use, most certainly Facebook VR, YouTube VR, Unity Game Development Engine, they're all set up so that they are working with ambisonics component ordering. So you should be fine for most of the part. So, and that's pretty much it. So we covered everything. We covered how to produce ambisonics audio. We covered how to monitor ambisonics audio. We covered how to record it. And now it's really up to you. Use it, have fun, create. Once again, not a lot of people are doing it right now. So a very good moment to get started. And other than that, have fun and thank you for watching. Thank you.